Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to our survival playthrough. So, last time, we escaped the vault and headed to Sanctuary Hills, picked up a few useful bits and pieces, and as you can clearly see, I've done a few little things off camera, which I will talk you through in just a moment, and we'll pick up our playthrough just after where we left off. So, we're in Sanctuary Hills, and off-camera, I've had a bit of a run around, created a bit of a settlement for you. It started out life as a sort of a home base bunker setup that I did off-camera, and kind of got out of hand on me, but it still works, so it looks pretty cool. So I'm sure many of you have seen my other settlement builds, you can understand why it got out of hand on me. A quick run around so you can see what I've done. The actual build tour should be popping up on screen any time now for you. So we've got a front gate. I've used the Unlock Settlement Objects mod to put most of this stuff in place. So we've got chain link fences around the place. Whilst our fellow Henry Avery here is not the nicest man around, he's going to have a practical streak. So we've got some space for other people to live. I've decided to put everybody else into what was originally the sole survivor's house. I thought I'd left the grognak there for a minute, but I haven't. So this is pretty basic, pretty Spartan, but it'll give our settlers somewhere to crash out. What's in here? I didn't leave that there. Thanks, guys. So yeah, this is somewhere for our settlers to hang out, sleep. They're basically going to live in here. A bit of AC decoration going on. Either the settler or possibly my character, I'm not sure which. Probably the character quite likes motorbikes, apparently. So, there we have one. Have I shoved that right to the door? No, just very close to it. That's okay, then. So, cool little garage there. Shored up the house a little bit. Put a ton more plants around. These come from the wild plants and alcohol mod, which, as you can see, our settlers are able to farm. So I can grab extra bits and pieces there, which is useful on a survival playthrough. On the whole, I'm trying to keep it relatively lore-friendly with the survival build. I absolutely love this. I've glitched benches into those stone blocks so that hopefully people will actually sit there. Yeah, I'm trying to keep it relatively survival lore-friendly.
This ain't.
But on the other hand, we've all done the game for so long, I'm not being too religious about that, hence the simple green and stuff. Try to make life a little bit more interesting. Potato farm back there. Yeah, so I've set it up so that I've got a few essentials here for survival playthrough. I needed somebody to farm and stuff, so he's going to have a few settlers around. This is my home slash bunker. It's a workshop house that I've just reinforced a bit. Chopped down a few bits and pieces, so it's got a few creature comforts. Very useful, decontamination arch and chem station, and our bedroom. Everybody needs an alarm clock. Oh yeah. So, with that out of the way, oh drat, that's alright, I didn't do that. Yeah, nearly locked myself out then, that would have been very inconvenient. So the plan to start off here is to show you a few little things that are easily accessible in the early game that you can pick up and make a survival playthrough a lot easier, but aren't too cheaty or game breaking or immersion breaking, anything like that. So we came out here and I have recently discovered there's a useful little object just over this hill, so which I had absolutely no idea was here, so let's see if we can find it, shall we? I haven't gone looking for it yet, so come on, if I can actually get up here. There we go. Is this it? Nope. Oh, yes. Yes, it is. Some stim pack and some ammo. Anything else in here? Yeah, another stim pack. That's cool. I had no idea this was here. Still finding stuff in this game, even a year on. Right, let's trundle along here. I'm going to try and avoid showing you stuff that's too boring and obvious, or edit out dull stuff for the most part. So that's the plan, anyway. We have a mongrel. So, see if we can take him out before he sees us. Put your head back. Oh, you annoying sod. Get up. Thank you. Well, he's not picked us up yet, even though I've shot him, which is cool. Oh wait, maybe he has. Come on, hit him. Thank you. So as you can probably see, I've fed the rules ever so slightly and picked up Maxim's battle coat. Because it doesn't provide that heavier armor boost. And it looks damn sight cooler than anything I could normally pick up. And as we've all seen the game countless times before, I thought, let's do something a bit more interesting. So, I don't figure it's too horribly immersion-breaking. Just grab some water. Yep. So yeah, it's... Yeah, I realise he's come out looking like an older Maxim, I think I said last time. There's enough differences for me, I think. So yeah, it's not totally immersive, but I could very easily pick up, you know, road leathers and some leather armour from raiders very early on that would provide as much or possibly even more protection than Maxim's battle coat does, so it's not like I'm giving myself an unfair advantage here. At least I don't think I am anyway. Money, money, money. Pick it up. This is the thing we're really here for, though. The Snubnose 44. Some tin cans if you happen to feel up inclined. Oh, cool. Milk bottle. Weapon box. Weapon. Military cap. Yeah, I did try out a military cap on this guy. It really didn't suit him, so... Now, there is a way to jump up here if it's not being too temperamental. There we go. Right away. Purified water and a Radex. Very nice. Now... Normally, I'd head off in this direction, if we just move around here, and look for the robotics disposal ground, and pick up a fat man. But I think I might do it anyway. Although it does have the slight drawback that the fat man's so damn heavy, it's not really practical for a survival playthrough anyway. God, this looks so pretty. I love it. That was disappointing. But there's a couple of useful bits and pieces up there, so we'll go ahead and grab it anyway, I think. So, robotics disposal ground. Fat man, but no ammo, apparently. Sentry bot, we can wake him up and take advantage of him. Fusion core, that's always a bonus. Although very heavy from what I understand. Let's have a look, shall we? Nope. Get the right button, might help. It's not like I haven't been playing this game for ages. £4. It's not horrific, but I wouldn't want to carry hundreds like I do on my other playthroughs. That's just the front of the car. Handy mini nuke if I can get hold of it. Thank you. Oh yes, more goodies. So a bit more light on this. I'm not going to grab that because it doesn't have a great deal of useful stuff in it. Rudder. Always good. That's nice. So, yeah, I think that's everything in here. So, play the tape. Wonderful. At least he won't attack me anyway. Thank you. So we'll take the holotape. So it means I can tell the robot outside what to do. Always good. Not quite sure what I qualify as. Both, I guess. As a former soldier. Some hot flour up here, so I'll grab that. Okay. So, just down here is our first power armor. So, see if we can take this radstag out. Yes, we can. Can I hit this one? Yes. Let's move on a little bit. Radstag mate is very useful. I'm quite pleased that this gun is proving to be as effective as it is for now. Balls. Eh, crap. Oh well. Cross that bridge when we come to it. So, what have we got here? No arms, but otherwise. I think I'll leave that. It's 245. And, as I say, there's no arms on it, so I can get a better version in a short while anyway. Where was that other red stack I shot? Don't know, but there's a piece of him that'll do. Hot flower. We'll avoid going over there because there's raiders. We'll deal with those at a later date. Ooh, cool. Sniper ammo. I'm actually going after a sniper rifle in just a moment, so right away, that's always worth having. I think that's most everything that's around here. So, let's make our way back to Sanctuary and then drop off some of what we've acquired. Oh shit. Where are you? Oh, awesome. This is not good, though. Where are you? There you are. Let's try and stay out of sight, shall we? Make them come to me. Even though I've been hit, I'm surviving reasonably well. That's unexpected. There you are. Come on. Yeah. How did he get hurt? Oh, well. Does not look a gift horse in the mouth. Can still hear you. Oh shit. Nice. I see you. Nice. So I've never really used pipe guns before, but I can't really complain about the effectiveness of this one, can I? Pleasantly surprised. Huh. Apparently he lost some body parts. Oh, awesome, did I manage to headshot him? Nuts, didn't even realise. Maybe that's the... Oh, I see, alright. Maybe that's the one I used. Vats on. What's the word I'm looking for? No, I don't think I want any of that. Right then, so we're back in Sanctuary. Had a little nap and dropped off various bits and pieces we picked up so we're not overburdened anymore. And I'm just going to cook up some food. And some beverages. I don't want to make dirty water, I think this is a mod addition. But let's grab some purified water. There we go. We got that we can cook up here. Red roach, lovely. Some red stag, it's got to be worthwhile. Especially that helps to carry weight for a bit. More rat, there we go. Some food. Some nut chops. Cooked meat is pretty much the best way you're going to get of getting food on a survival playthrough. Weighs the least, has the most reward, and it's the least likely to make you ill as well. So that's what we're doing here. Don't think I'm gonna do that. Okay. So our farmer's hanging around. Apparently she's wandered over and opened the gate for absolutely no reason at all. I don't know why they have a habit of doing that, but if you want to let anybody who attacks wander into the settlement, by all means, make it easy for them. Anyway. So, I'm going to push on again. Close the gate behind me, because I'm obsessive about that. I do like that place. And we're going to go and have a look for a few more useful bits and pieces. There's a couple of good weapons that you can pick up very early on, very easily. And if you, well, if you know what you're doing anyway. So we're going to have a run over and head for those. And this makes for a much stronger start on your survival playthrough. As you may have noticed, I'm companion free at the moment. As I'm sure many of you know by now, Lone Wanderer. Oh, cool. Oh yes, I forgot to mention this. Underground Railroad is a mod that allows you a variant on fast travel. So, should we have a quick look at that? I'd forgotten I'd installed this. But it's designed for survival mode. And it provides a kind of almost player home, I think, as well. I haven't actually looked at it yet, as I say. And once you find the manhole scattered around... Well, that wasn't really part of the plan, but... I'm going to head that way eventually, actually, because I want to join up with the Brotherhood of Steel as a means of getting something vaguely resembling fast travel. Anyway, let's have a look around. So yeah, this is the Underground Railroad. Doesn't seem to want to activate. Oh, awesome, we've got a workshop. I did not know this. So, we could build this into a kind of cool player home. I might... We might actually end up with a unplanned build here. It's quite cool. These various gates lead off to different areas of the Commonwealth where there are manholes. You're supposed to find the manhole first and then use it to make your way back into here. But it's a survival mode quick travel mod sort of thing, so you move around much more easily. If you get it in the right way, you should be able to activate the chain and actually take it off from this side, which is a bit naughty, and I haven't decided if I'm going to do that yet. What have we got here? Some food, an explorer outfit, 10mm pistol and some ammo, some copper. Oh, that's kind of cool. Fiberglass. Antibiotics, that's, I need that. So I'll grab that. And a map of all the manhole covers, I'm guessing. That's obviously upside down. So, up here, that's Sanctuary. That's supposed to be where we are. Let's see another one here. Over here. That's very vague. I assume there's a good reason for that. But that's pretty cool. Hmm. So, yeah. Somewhere down here, we should be able to tell roughly where it comes out. But I can't, typically. Anyway. So, that's basically the mod. So, we'll head back out. So yes, as I was saying, companion free. And... if you've got the Lone Wanderer perk, normally that gets disabled when you take a companion, but dog meat, as you probably have discovered by now, is the exception to that. So we might do a bit of travelling with dog meat.
Hey, boy. What are you doing out here all by yourself?
Normally he's an angry type, but... Let's not be unpleasant to dog meat.
Okay, then. Let's stick together.
Oh, no, you don't. Bang. Bang. Good night. Goddamn Morox. Leave my dog alone. So let's put Blitz to good use. Come on. Eventually. Dog meat looks like he's finished off the other fella for us. Yeah, wonderful.
Yeah.
So. Now we've met dog meat. Let's get away from that thistle, because that'll probably hurt me. We'll head up this way. Find another couple of useful bits and pieces that I did know about. This is the Concord Water Tower. See Conk out in the distance over there. And we've got a couple of handy bits and pieces knocking around here. If you follow it just a little bit south, chances are Dogmeat will find this for you anyway. Somewhere here. There should be a chest. There it is. So it's some ammo. I'm not going to bother with the armour, but if one does need it, there it is. Abernathy Farm just over there. Concord over here. So we're on the edge of Concord here. It looks so much prettier. So if we head on down there, obviously we end up in Concord. I don't really want to do that just yet. Start with that. Bang! Thank you. Oh god, they did some damage. Don't really know what the proboscis is any use for, but we'll grab it just in case I figure it out. Need a drink anyway, so... And what we got here? Oh, I see, it's a purified water effect. Some hop flower. Ooh, caps. Sweater vest and slacks, won't bother with that. I'll have the ammo, thank you very much. If you'd shift out the way, dog meat, that would make life a little bit easier.
Yes.
Ooh, cool. At that weight, I'm not going to bother with missiles. My porto pistol. Not going to bother with that either, they tend to be not very much use. Useful bits and pieces there, though. I would take the missiles to sell, but it's so heavy it's not very worth it. Oh, cool. Instant mash, not really very good food, that. Bit too heavy, really, but... For now... I think that's everything down on this level. So we can nip up the hill here. He says... And this is what we're looking for. So, I've got a few wild meat fruit. Brahmin corpse. And our dead raider. Now, I'm not really into the shotgun, but it's useful for the settlers. Got a bit of ammo, armour rather. A few bits and pieces. Red roach meat, and this is it, the combat knife. Which is a very handy melee weapon. And is so it's a fast melee weapon and does a respectable amount of damage. Our tire iron's on 28, which is considerably more, but weighs more, and we won't get the same attack speed out of it. So This is more easy to upgrade as well. So, that's the first big thing. Or little thing. Let's have a quick look over Concord and see how it looks with the mod on. Pretty nice. Does look good. So, drop down here nice and not nearly carefully enough, apparently. Now you can explore through all the buildings and find bits and pieces as well if you like, but I will probably do that at a later date. So we're avoiding meeting up with Preston and everybody just yet. Because they're just up there in the Museum of Freedom. A little bit closer than I'd like to be because I can hear the gunfire. But let's just quickly clean this place out. Because this is the house I wanted to find. Awesome, some chems. As useful as chems are, particularly on survival, they do have the drawback of dehydrating you and giving you other negative effects. So, I'll be a bit judicious as to whether or not I use them. There we are, that's what we're looking for. Pipe sniper rifle. And I'll have that as well. And some more armour. So, as you can see, I could very easily have a pretty decent armour rating already. So I don't feel too bad about cheating in Maxon's battle gate. There we go.
Nice.
Oh, awesome. Especially those 45 rounds. Leave the rest of that off. That's my weight looking heavier than I'd like, but it'll do for now. So... place I want to head to now is off in this direction. I'm slightly concerned about what I might run into. Jules and Angie. Okay. Not raiders, that's amazing.
You ain't gonna rat us out to the Institute. Don't come any closer, friend. This doesn't concern you.
Please, help! They're going to kill me!
Shut up!
What's going on here?
This thing's a synth. That's what. We've been traveling with it for weeks.
That guy looks more like a synth to me than the other one.
He's an Institute errand boy. The whole fucking time.
Because I thought you were my friend.
I'd never be friends with a damn synth.
You already were friends with the synth. Now please, just let me go.
You think I'm stupid? You're just gonna run off and get your Institute buddies to come put us down. That ain't happening, pal.
I'm not with the Institute. I ran away. I just need to get to Bunker Hill. Then I swear I will never bother you again. Please. You believe me, right? You can't let them do this.
Oh, why in the hell would the Institute be interested in those guys anyway? Risk entering the Institute... well, there's a fair point. But we're an aggressive type.
You don't need to be afraid of the Institute. You let him go, or I'll kill you both myself.
Like hell you will.
Have it your way.
Well, not quite what I had in mind. Oh, shite. Well, let's find out how good this is then, shall we? Well, I've got a lot of action points on to use for it. Critical strike certainly helped. Oh, hell, I'm in a bad way now. Have to use the stim pack, which is not so great for my hydration level, but gotcha. Apparently he wasn't particularly intimidated by me, though. Yep. Let's go and give Andrew what for. Oh! And there we have our first survival death. And that's going to take me a long way back. Right then, I guess I'll get back to where we were off camera then, shall we? Right then, So we've made our way back to where we were prior to getting killed. And as we can see, I don't think we've got a random encounter down here this time. So hopefully we won't make foolish choices and die. Can I open this? Yes, I can. Whoops, forgot about that. Oh, man. At least I've got plenty of bobby pins at the minute. So, yes. I don't think we did quite as well on our return journey for... ooh, maybe we did. Our various drops. But we've done okay. Picked up all the bits and pieces we acquired on the way down. Just the sugar bombs, though. Although this time, I ran into some blight flies on the way down and picked up a parasite infection from them, which I'm not very happy about. Dead settlers. No. We've got a few useful bits and pieces. A few caps. Empty milk bottle, I'll have that. Nothing in there. Ramen meat. Not that bothered about the wine, I don't think. Oh, crap! Oh, dear. Well, those weren't there last time. That's kind of rained on my parade a little bit, hasn't it? Best stim packet. Otherwise I won't heal my limbs. Looks like they've all gone off, so... Witness the slower healing from stim packs, which is part of the reason I got myself sorted last time. Little annoyed that that didn't show up on VATS actually, although I suppose it's hiding behind the tyres. Well, that was interesting. So, push on where we were going to head before. We're going to make our way back around Concord. Preferably without triggering anybody. Now then. So I need to make sure I'm going in the right direction, which I think I am. Yes, I believe so. So this road should take us off towards the west and over to Alden Pond. And the dam just above it. This bridge is a random encounter point. So, what's going on in the distance there? There's somebody over there. Appears to be getting butchered. Which probably means whoever's doing the butchering is not somebody I want to run into. That's some settlers, or it appears to be. Let's go say hello. Seems to have fought somebody.
Out here, you got to take things one day at a time.
Well. Oh.
If you ain't been up to see Greygarden, you should...
Hi.
Easy living, this ain't.
Need to get back to Diamond City one of these days.
Well, I was hoping I could invite them back to Sanctuary, but no such joy. So apparently they've managed to take out some raiders. That's pretty impressive. So You're not going to complain about that. There's just a few. I could probably have taken them out myself, but... You know. Walden Pond looks pretty nice like this. There's a few useful bits and pieces down there if you do feel like going and taking out some raiders, but we're not going to do that just yet. We're going to head up this way. Apparently, tow pumped a entire car tyre. Because that's hyper realistic. Yeah, awesome. Yes, you may have noticed I've got the Silence Avant mod running, so you don't have to listen to it squawk every time I pick up her. Every time Idiot's Avant. What's the word I'm looking for? Triggers, what's the word? There's the other one. Oh crap, he's legendary. Oh, but Dogmeat's taking him down, that's pretty cool. Let's see if I can take him out in one. Yes! So he didn't even mutate, there's a winner. On the other hand, that'll be our first legendary enemy. What have you got for me then? Penetrating pipe auto pistol. 30% of damage and energy resistance ignored. That's pretty cool. Good, it's only novice. So there's a few medical items in here which are worth grabbing while we're here.
Got it.
Leave me alone. Damn road roaches. Right. So there's some junk right away. Stimpak, wonderful. Stimpak purified water, even better. Chef hat, cool. What does that do for me? Extra luck. It's not the worst idea ever. Don't think I want to run around in a chef's hat though. Relics as well. Wonderful. Grab a pistol. Oh, wonderful, you're dead. I don't have to deal with you. So this is Sunshine Tidings, as I'm sure you're well aware. Settlement location. It's quite cool. I have to think of something interesting to do here at some point. Is it pretty? Ah, yes. You're not so dead, are you? So Big Leagues is the one that I've got, so let's leap in here and try and sneak attack with maximum damage. There we go. Yeah, like that. Brain fungus. Drugs, not particularly fussed about those. Settler, who didn't... Get out of the way, dog meat. Didn't go very well for... Not got anything very interesting, I don't think. No. Just grab the food. Yeah. Mattress, don't want that. Bottle cap. Ammo, yes, definitely need that. Not so fussed about that, am I? Heavy hunting rifle. That's pretty good. Ported hardened pipe pistol. That might be useful. And Raider chest piece. No, I don't want that. Hardened receiver. No, I don't think it will be very much use, actually. Quick eject mag's kind of handy, but... Yeah, I'm going to get rid of my pipe weapons before long, so I won't bother. Sure will, just for the ammo.
Hell yeah.
That's what we're really here for. Wasteland Survival Guide. Getting extra meat from animal kills. I don't think there's very much more I want from here. Just a quick shifty around anyway. the wonder glue. Red Roach. Can I get him? Oh, legendary Red Roach. I can as well. Let's put a few in there. See if we... Oh, yes. Nice. Bloodied combat knife. Does more damage the lower your health is. Not really sure I want my health dropping down, but it's better than the one we've got, so... That's pretty cool. Which means that one I'll drop because it's just extra weight. It's only a pound, but this is survival after all. And we'll head on to the next big thing we want, which is a bit of a runaway. I'm going to be careful because that's a gunner camp up there. And probably a little premature getting involved in that right now. Lonely chapel over there. Let's see if we can grab this. Wonderful. 2 XP and another map marker. It's not particularly helpful given that we're on survival, but somewhere just down here, there is a raider camp. That's it there. So we're going to try and skirt around this very carefully. Because they will not be very happy to see me, and they will more than likely slaughter me, so... Certainly at this stage, anyway. There we go. So, sneaky, sneaky, sneaky. There's also some power armor down there if you happen to be... on the hunt for it. Oh dear. Oh, you're a wild monger, I can deal with that. Awesome, and we've leveled as well. Nice. Shall we have a look at this level then? A few levels out. Blitzes a lot of levels out. Strong back never hurts. Blacksmith. We're going to have that. Because I could start upgrading my weapons then. I did think about grabbing sneak, but... That can wait, I think. Especially as we're on the hunt for weapons right now. So, now we're getting out of the initial starting zone. We are on into slightly more dangerous territory now. What did you find, dog meat? Cooking pot, always good. Wonderful. And of course we'll get a few XP for it as well. Grab any Coca-Cola. Not bothered about the cigarettes. Oh dear, there's a raider around here. Crap, he spotted me. Oh shit. Oh, hell no. That really did not go well, did it? Right then, ladies and gents. So, made our way back to Sunshine Tidings. I've decided to be slightly smarter about it this time. So we've had a run around, picked up a few bits and pieces. No legendary drops this time, sadly. So I've lost that awesome combat knife, which is a bit sad. But I've unlocked the settlement this time and had a kip here, which is why it's dark. So it's actually now about 6 in the morning or so. So we have an autosave here now. So if I get myself slaughtered again, at least I won't have to run back, like make my whole way back from Sanctuary again, which I've had to do like twice now. So there we go, this is the place that I got killed. I'm going to stay well clear of you this time. And I know I'm hungry, but I'm not stopping anywhere near here until I've acquired a nice safer spot, I think. Penalty. There we go, properly fed again. There shouldn't be too much trouble here, he says. Yeah, I ran into some raiders on the way down and took them out without too much difficulty. Oh, my luck. Let's stay well clear of that. Yeah, it took me without too much difficulty, but it did cost me most of my sniper ammo, which was unfortunate, but what can you do? Keep plodding on. There's all manner of stuff around here I could explore, but it's a little early for that. Where are we on the map? Yeah. So. Oops. I suspect everybody knows where we are now. This is Fort Hagen. Or the vicinity of. And there are a few guaranteed drops around here, and that's what we're looking for. I'm not going to go and help those guys out. Whatever's going on is probably way beyond what I can cope with right now, so we'll steer well clear, I think. However, this pub should be nice and empty, so. Well, empty of trouble, anyway. Beer bottles. Definitely. Get Get out of the way, dog meat. Come on. You'll get sent back if you keep this crap up. So there's a few useful bits and pieces here if you're looking for junk. I'm not. I don't know why I picked that up. Awesome, 3 fusion cores, I'll have that. 6 missiles, I won't bother with those. I'm not going to bother with those either. So that went better on the whole than I expected. Can't complain. So, there we go, Fort Hagen. Okay, if that's all we're finding. Nothing of any interest there. No, not that. There we go. So, this is where we want to be. Boom. Very nice. Well. Got there. Where are you? There you are. Balls. Oh, I'll worry about you in a minute. You're only a bloke fly. Gotcha. You're slightly more troubling. Or not. Greater Mass Blood Clinic, this is what we're looking for. And I'll watch out because there are mines around here. That's why the scavenger's not having a great time. Come on, dog mate. Good work, buddy. There you go. But I certainly won't say no to the ammunition. Hmm. 200 years later, spotlights are still working. Might be worth having. Probably nothing very interesting. In terms of risk and reward, this is epically good. There's never really much in the way of enemies here beyond a few bloodbugs and bloatflies. Unless you decide to go down to the basement, which we'll see how lucky we feel in a bit. But the reward is huge. Oh dear. That's considerably more problematic. So let's do this. You're off me. Oh, that didn't go off as well as I was hoping it would. Right. So let's take advantage of the fact I've accidentally opened this up. Oh, crap. Oh, it did not go so well. Right then, let's try this again, shall we? So it's kind of funny, really. Coming back down here, somewhat annoying after I died. But on the other hand, there's across the bridge back there that you saw a couple of minutes ago. Last time I decided to avoid it. This time, there were a couple of raiders fighting a few settlers. The settlers were doing an impressive job of holding their own. So, for the cost of one sniper shot, I was able to help them finish it off. And underneath that bridge, there is a very handy little stash of items. So I picked up a few useful bits of pieces, a couple of stim packs, some caps as well, and this little beauty. It's just sitting there on the shelf. You have to kind of jump up at it, it's up in the air, and there is a trap under there, which I got lucky and didn't set off, because it's a grenade bouquet, so I should have an extra frag grenade here as well. Yeah, that's a sniper rifle much better than what I had before, which is awesome. Hopefully it'll make life a little bit easier this time. It's just suspiciously quiet and far too easy at this stage. Literally making me extremely paranoid. Why I still have my overly large gun out. Even though I've only got 2 shots. Up onto the roof, which is where we want to be. Okay. It seemed to be reasonably easy. So, cap stash. Ammo, nothing else that's particularly useful. What have we got here? Yes, great, some ammo. Especially 45 rounds, because over here we have what we came for. Yeah, nothing interesting there. And there it is, a short combat rifle. Now, assuming you don't get slaughtered too many times on your way down here, you'll find that there every single time, so. It's nice, much more reliable. Crispy squirrel bits, if I can say that. So yeah, you've got a nice, relatively high-powered weapon for the early stages of the game. Acquired what should be relative ease. Let's grab a quick hour's snooze on here, so that we can save. So, there we go. We now have a short combat rifle. I didn't really have that in mind. Congratulations. You found a locked door. And open that door from all the way up here, apparently. Advanced now, I'll be able to open that. Now then. This is where we could be approaching trouble. So. Well, I got away with mucking that up ever so slightly. Show yourself. Come on. Oh. Here, there you go. Oh my god, you're the legendary one. Right. On the other hand, not so long since we saved it, so if it goes utterly balls up, at least it won't be the end of the world. Oh crap. Oh, something went down. Move, dog meat. Come on, you're so annoying. I'll be damned. Nimble. That's pretty cool. 75% faster aiming. It has somewhat overburdened me though, I think. Yeah.
Yo, psst.
Not so much in the sights department, but you know. Ooh! Well. Could have gone horribly wrong. Somehow it didn't. Blowed if I know how, but, you know. Well, this is really not going to end well, is it? Let's see if we take his wings out, if that'll help. Nope, it didn't. Oh well. This is why we saved. Cool as it would have been to keep the nimble mod. No such joy. Alright then. So that's all the big things we've come looking for. So I think we'll make our way back to Sanctuary and get ourselves situated again. I'll see you back there. Alright then, ladies and gents. So we're back in Sanctuary again. Ran into a few dogs and a few other bits and pieces on the way back. Nothing particularly fascinating. So we've cooked off some more meat. Dropped my various bits and pieces off. So I'm no longer carrying around half the world. I've upgraded my weapons a little bit. What's going on there? The sniper rifle that I did have, the hunting rifle based one, I've put aside for now as I haven't got very much ammo for it. The plan anyway is to move the combat rifle towards the sniper rifle, which I've now done. Slightly shorter range, not quite as much damage, but I'm carrying a lot more ammo for it, so it's much better. We've upgraded our combat knife, so it's now a serrated combat knife, which does bleed damage, which is great. That should be dishing out a lot more punishment. Bleed damage also stacks, so should allow us to be a lot more devastating when we need to get into close combat. And we'll hang on to the terminal lead, because it's handy to have for now. So dog meat's having a wander around. And I think we'll call it there for this episode, because we've picked up a fair bit of ground covered. So thank you very much for watching as always. If you'd like to, hit those buttons. You can follow me on social media as well. I'm on Twitter and Facebook. Just search slash Darth Xion Games. See you soon.